face coming to your screen in a few seconds. Okay, bye.
The verse just in time, reverb at 4 or 5. Gotta rep the new mix by 8 a.m. Drums first, then the guitar. The wordsmith's working hard to record the best art we can for you. Well, you know what I've been told, you need a full band to run this show. And I can't do this all on my own, but I kinda do, and I'll show you how at the Triple Llama. I can't write a song,
everybody. This is my Fender Jazz bass. We're going to be using it to record the bass track on Hyperdrive, which is the song that we are recording this weekend. Bass is a powerful instrument, and that's a good thing, but sometimes it can be a little much. A strong signal can overwhelm a DAW, it can distort the sound, it can change the tone, all kinds of things that we don't want. One way that we can solve this is with this little device. This is called an attenuator. So this particular attenuator is adjustable. We can lower by 15, 20, or 25 decibels. I usually leave it at 15. This Fishman DI can be used both with guitar and bass. There is a bass setting, so we're going to switch that. There's also some tonal controls that I'm going to adjust later. The attenuator is going to go... There we go. The XLR cable, the microphone cable that in this case we're going to use as an instrument cable, going to go there. So now we have this rather unwieldy but effective solution. So we're going to put one end of the guitar cable into the bass, and then the other end here into the quarter inch jack of the Fishman, and then go out from that with an XLR cable, hello puppy, into the audio interface. And of course it is going to go through the attenuator on the way, and we're going to get a lower decibel level. All right, so now our bass track is ready, but the tone, I'm not loving it. I mean, it's fine, but I need something a little bit deeper, something that's got a little more presence. But I can't turn the volume up, because that's going to cause problems. Now, to get the tone that we want, we're going to use something called Blue Cat's Patch Bay, a virtual patch bay that essentially acts as an organizer for different types of plugins and lets you run any combination of them simultaneously. So we're going to take Patchwork from the right-hand side. We are going to drag it here onto the bass track that we have created. It turns out that I have a bass setting that I normally use. Is going to bring up this. This is my standard bass preset. We've got Bark of Dog 2, which is a nifty plugin by Boz Digital Labs. It allows us to identify a particular frequency and then increase the volume of just that frequency. We have a subfilter, which increases the bass. We've got an analog saturator here. There's a lot of debate about what is a better method of recording, analog or digital. For me, analog is definitely the way to go if you can manage it. Unfortunately, in a modern DAW, you kind of can't. So the best that we can do, or at least the best that I can do, is to simulate it as best we can. Well, preset is applied, so let's see what that sounds like. now we're ready to record. So let us do a bass track on top of the guitar tracks that we've already recorded.
Just experienced CamannWordsmith playing the bass.
Oh, what? Okay, we're not doing that anymore. Thank you so much, CamannWordsmith patrons. We'll see you next time. Bye! Not goodbye just yet, as it turns out. It is a week later. I originally had posted this on January 5th, and then we took it offline. Turns out that every instance where I am playing the bass was really super distorted, and that's because I recorded it at such a low level that when I tried to normalize it, it destroyed the waveform. All the bass has been done properly, and it has now been overdubbed. So, pro tip, when you are recording, record at a level that does not destroy your track. Yay! Okay, now we're gonna go, and we'll see you in episode 3. Okay, bye!